Good morning, students. Welcome you all in English class. Today I am going to teach you a new poem, The Shell. Poem 3, this is from your Honeycomb book. The poet of this poem is Frank Fleeg. Shell. What is a shell? You may have heard tool shell, cow shell, and wood shell. Shell is actually a small room which is away from your main house. This is we generally use to keep or store our old things, items, vehicles, tools, and sometimes animals. I think you understood what shed I am talking about. In this poem, the poet also has a small shed at the bottom of his garden. He described this shed, which is in the worst condition, and what he thinks about the shed. This is we are going to learn in this poem. So, let's enjoy the poem. Before starting the poem, I would like to introduce a poet of the poem, Frank Fleeg. Francis Stanislaus Fleeg was born on 6 December 1906 in Sydney, and he was died on 29 July 2000. Some of his famous books are The Living Heart, Northern Gateway, Rebuilding the Beacon, Point Smith, Port Essington. Let's start the poem. Stanza 1. Students, you also can open your book with me and read the poem. There is a shed at the bottom of our garden, with a spider's web hanging across the door. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. When I am in bed, I lie and I listen. I will open the door one day. The poet is here, a small boy, who is a narrator, who is describing his shed which is at the bottom of the garden. He is describing here the condition of the shed, which is really worst. So let's listen. The poet says that at the bottom of the garden there is a shed. Hardly anybody goes inside the shed because it's very cold. Therefore, the hinges of the door joints have become rusty and make a lot of noise whenever the wind makes them move. And the spider's webs are hanging across the door. These descriptions shows that the shed is very old, in the worst condition, and nobody goes there. When the poet is peacefully lying in the bed, whenever in the night he goes to sleep, he sometimes hears noises from the shed. This noise is what? It is the creaking sound of the door. This, whenever he heard the creaking sound, he wishes to be able to open the door of the ship someday. I think you understood stanza 1, the condition of the ship. Now stanza 2. There is a dusty old window around at the side. With 3 cracked panes of glass, I often think there is someone staring at me. Each time that I pass, I peep through that one day. Here, the poet discusses how he wishes to stare inside the shed while looking at the window panes. What he realizes, the poet says that the shed has a dusty old window on its side. And this old window has 3 glass panes which are broken. Whenever the poet passes through the shed, he gets the feeling as if someone was staring at him. To find out the truth, he said, and he wishes to peep inside the shed one day. Understood? Second stanza. So, second stanza, in this, the poet wishes to stare inside the shed. Now, stanza 3. My brother says there is a ghost in the shed who hides under the rotten floorboards. And if I ever dare to set foot inside, he will jump out and chop off my hat. But I'll take a peek one day. Here, in these lines, the poet discusses how his brother warns him about the ghost inside the shed. So, the poet's brother talks about the presence of the ghost inside the shed. What he says? His elder brother says that there is a ghost inside the shed. And if I dare to go inside the shed, he would jump out and he would chop off his hat. However, this does not much frighten the poet, because he understood that the intention of his brother to make him scared. He still wished that after hearing the warning of his brother, he still wished that one day I'll step out inside the shed and see for himself whether there is a ghost or not. So somewhere from inside the heart, he knows that there is no ghost. It is just his brother saying to make him scared from the shed. And he wanted to make him keep away himself from the shed. Now, stanza 4. I know that there is not really a ghost. My brother tells lies to keep the shed for his dame. There is not anyone staring or making strange noises, and the spider has been gone from his web. Since I don't know when I will go into the shed, one day soon, but not just yet. Here in this poem, in these lines, the poet seemed to have grown enough to understand the truth. He is quite mature and he understood the truth. He says, I am able to overcome my fear. In these lines, through these lines, we understand that the poet has overcome his fears. He is able to understand that there is no ghost inside the shed. He understands that there is actually nobody inside the shed who stares at him or makes those strange noises. Nobody is there. And the spider too is no longer there. His brother had been telling him lies because he wanted to retain the shed for his own self. He wanted to possess the shed. Therefore, very soon the poet would be able to set in foot inside the shed. However, he says that this can't be happened immediately. So, the poem is very interesting. I hope you understood the poem. Here the summary of the poem. The poem is about the shed, which is a small room away from the main house. It is located at the bottom of the poet's garden. It is in the worst condition. Whenever poet passes through it, he feels somebody is staring at him. His brother threatens him by saying that a ghost stays in the shed who hides himself under the rotten floorboards, who may jump and attack on the poet. In fact, there is no ghost inside the shed. His brother tells him lie to keep the shed for his dame. At last, the poet overcomes his fear by saying that he'll enter the shed any day soon. Now, student, as we all know that if there is a poem, of course there is a rhyming scheme. So let's find out, is there a rhyming scheme in this? What is a rhyming scheme? Rhyming scheme, you all know very well this phrases we have learned in our previous poems also. Rhyming schemes we take out with the help of rhyming words. And rhyming words are there in the end of every lines of the poem. If we have same sounding words, then we will mark it A. And then next same sounding word we have to mark B. In this way we take out a rhyming scheme. So let's see, do we have a rhyming scheme in this poem? See, there is a shed at the bottom of our garden. The last word is garden. So you will mark it A. With the spider's web hanging across the door. Door is the last word. Does it rhyme with garden? No. So you will mark it B. The hinges are rusty and creak in the wind. Wind. Does it rhyme with other two words? No. Then mark it C. Every words are different. When I am in bed, I lie and I listen. Listen. Does it match with other? No. D. I'll open the door one day. Does it rhyme? No. So next, E. In this way, the rhyming scheme is A, B, C, D, E. It means all words, all is rhyming. There is no rhyme. If there is no rhyme, it is called free verse. The poet has not used any rhyming scheme. If we don't have rhyming scheme, that is called a free verse. Understood? So you will, if I ask you to take out rhyming scheme, then you will take out in this same way. Now the next three stanza rhyming scheme you have to take out and take out by your own. Whether do we have a rhyming scheme in other stanza or not? If not, it is coming out in the same way, A, B, C, D, E. It means that is a free verse. I hope it is clear to you and you can understand the poem and the rhyming scheme very well. Thank you, student.